हेलो स्टूडेंट्स,
सो वेलकम अगेन। हेयर आई एम विद अनदर लेक्चर ऑन इंजीनियरिंग ग्राफिक्स एंड अवर टॉपिक कोनिक सेक्शन। दिस टाइम आई एम गोइंग टू ड्रॉ अ हाइपरबोला विद दिस आर्क ऑफ सर्कल्स मेथड। एज यू रिमेंबर अर्लियर आई हैव डिफाइंड दैट हाइपरबोला इन द फॉर्म ऑफ द लोकस ऑफ ए पॉइंट। व्हाट वी डिफाइंड दैट ए हाइपरबोला कैन बी डिफाइंड एज द लोकस ऑफ ए पॉइंट विच मूव्स इन अ प्लेन इन सच ए वे so that the difference of the distance from the two fixed point remains same or constant, and those two fixed points will be the focus, and that fixed distance will be equals to transverse axis. This you have already studied in the mathematics also. So in the same definition form I have taken this problem. In the problem they are saying trace the locus of a point such that the difference between the distance of the points from the two fixed points 90 mm apart is constant and is equals to 60 mm. And they also ask about the name of the curve, so the name of the curve will be a hyperbola. If I want to start this problem, then we should begin with these two points which are 90 mm apart. So what I have done here, I am starting with two points. There are these two points. This will be our F1, that is the focus one, and this will be F2. The distance between these two points will be 90 mm. These two points are 90 mm apart. Then, as they are saying that the difference of the distance will be 60 mm, so what I have done, that 90 minus 60, that is 30, so 30 divided by 2, so 15 from this will be the first vertices, that is V1, and 15 from this F2 will be our V2, and this V1 V2 will be equals to 60 mm, that is the difference of the distance, and that is also known as transverse axis. So this distance will be 60 mm. As we can easily justify that this V1 will be one of the point of the curve, because this V1 F2 minus V1 F1 will be equals to V1 V2. Same way this V2 can be justified, that V2 F1 minus V2 F2 will be equals to V1 V2. So what I am going to do, I am going to find some new points which can maintain this difference, that is equals to 60 mm. So for that, what I will start with marking a point. Suppose I will mark a point 1 on this line away from F2. I can take at any distance from this point 1, but suppose I have taken this distance 10 mm. Now what I am going to do, I am going to use the two distances. One will be V1 1, second one will be V2 1. I am going to use two distances, V1 1 and V2 1. As you know that the difference of these two distances will be V1 V2. So in this way I will maintain the difference of the distance, that is V1 V2. So what I am going to do, I will start with this distance initially V2 1. I am taking the distance V2 1 and center will be the focus F2. One arc upside, one arc downside, same radius from F1, one arc upside, one arc downside. So what I have done, by taking distance V2 1, I have marked 4 arcs, 2 on the left side, 2 on the right side. Next time I am going to pick this distance, that is V1 1, this is V1 1, again the center will be F1. So with the help of that F1, I will cut this arc on the right side, then F2 as radius, again same method, I will cut arc on this side. Now these four points, look at this point, the distance of this point from F1 will be V2 1, and the distance of the same point from F2 will be V21. So that difference will be V1, V2. So that is one of the point on the curve. Same way, these four points are similar points. So these four are the points which are the required points for our curve. Next time, again, what I am going to do, I will mark another point. Suppose 2, now the distance between 1 and 2 will be again 10 mm. This time I am going to use the two distances. The distance will be V2, 2 and V1, 2. Again, as you know, the difference of these two points will be, these two lengths will be V1, V2. So initially I will pick this distance, that is V2, 2. V2, 2 will be the radius. Again, the center will be F2, one arc upside, one arc downside. Same method with F1, one arc upside, one arc downside. Now, second time I am going to pick this distance, that is V1, 2. So pick V1, 2 from here. This is V1, 2. Now again, F1 will be the center. Cut the earlier arc. F2 as center. Cut this arc. Again, we will get four points, and these four points are again justifying our equation that the difference of the distance from the two fixed points F1, F2 remains same, that is equals to V1, V2. Numerically, that will be 60 mm. Again, moving forward, I will mark another point, suppose a point 3, again 10 mm from 2, and this time I am going to pick the two distances V2, 3 and V1, 3. Again, this combination will give me a difference that will be V1, V2. So firstly, I will pick this distance, that is V2, 3 and F2 as center, one arc upside, one arc downside, F1 as center, one arc upside, one arc downside. Same way V1, 3. So this V1, 3 I will pick from here. F1 will be the center, same radius, arcs. You can get three more points. Now if you look, the curve is almost started generating. If we like, we can take one more point, and I will take a last point, that will be maybe 4. Now this time I am going to use the two distances, that is V2, 4 and V1, 4. Again, the combination will be V1, V2. So now the distance, initially I will pick this V2, 4. Again, F1 will be, F2 will be the center, one arc upside, one arc downside. F1 will be the center, one arc upside, one arc downside. Now the reverse, V1, 4. Pick this distance V1, 4 from F1, cut this one, and F2, cut this opposite one. Now look at these points. We have multiple points. If I join all those points with the help of freehand or with the help of French curve, I can get the desired hyperbola. Same way in this side also. So this is the hyperbola using arc of circles method, justifying all those points which are making the difference of the distance from the two fixed points equals to 60 mm. If you want to draw a tangent and normal on this curve, then also I will show you the method. Suppose we want to draw a tangent and normal on any point that will be a P point on this curve. So the method will be, if you want to draw a tangent and normal on this point, so from this point, join this point P with F1 and F2, and this angle, bisect this angle with the help of arcs, and that angle bisector, if you want to bisect this, take one arc, then again with the same radius mark the arc on this, join this point with P. This line will be the tangent on the, this method will be same as we have applied in the case of ellipse. In the ellipse, case of ellipse, initially we will get the normal, then perpendicular to normal will be tangent. In this case, when I am bisecting this angle, we directly got the tangent. Now perpendicular to this tangent will be the normal. I hope you understand the concept. This is one of the very interesting problem. Again, definition based, try to solve this in your sketchbook. If you are having any doubts, you are free to ask me in next class. Thank you very much.